So here is your order of play today. We have done three finals already. We are now into the fourth of five matches. It's the men's singles.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Prannoy HS, the 16 from India, is up against China's Weng. It was an all-India semi-final, wasn't it? Prannoy taking on compatriot Priyanshu Rajawat in one half of the draw. Li Zijia, well, he was on the comeback trail, but he fell short against Weng Hongya. These two meeting in a repeat of the final a few months ago at the Malaysia Masters. It's varied, isn't it? Very nice and varied. Only China and Japan have more than one representative in the top eight. Remember,
let's welcome the players on the court. Prannoy HS from India.
Here is Prannoy HS, and people have asked, what does the HS stand for? It's Hasina Sunil.
And he takes on Weng Hongyang from China.
Weng Hongyang. I'll tell you what, these two countries have had plenty of support in the week here at the Key Center. So you're going to get plenty of noise. They've only met once before, and that was also in a final. That was at the end of June, end of May, I should say.
Okay, so Prannoy, would you like to call red or black? He chooses black, you have red. Okay, Peter,
pretty tight match that one was as well.
It is red. You choose the left side, you receive, you will be serving as well. Okay.
Weng Hongyang has been in four finals. He's won two and lost two. He has a pattern of winning one, losing one so far. It's how it's gone for him. Prannoy has been in six finals. He's won four of the six. So that last one that he won was against Weng Hongyang. Prannoy is 31 years of age. He's from Thiruppuram, formerly known as Trivandrum, in the state of Kerala, down south of India. And he's currently ninth in the world. His highest ranking was not too long ago achieved. It was seventh, just before he won the Malaysia Masters, in fact. And he's dropped games along the way, but look at that result. Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, he had to withstand the power of Ginting, who came back roaring. It looked like Ginting was going to cruise it after winning the first game, but he did so well, Prannoy. I'll talk more about his style in just a while. Weng Hongyang is 24. He's a taller man at 186, and he's from the south of China, in Fujian province. He's currently 24th, and his highest has been 23rd. That was in April earlier this year. Now he's won one title to his name, two times, Korea Open last year and 2019 Ling Shui China Masters. He has dropped two games along the way. Li Zijia, what a result that was. As look at that against Cho Tien Chen, very comfortable. That one was so, and then beating Kota Naraoka in the first round as well. So he's had a tougher route, as it were, as you'd expect. Jitin Bhatt from Australia is our umpire. Service judge Chiaki Miyazaki from Japan.
Oh,
overall, Prannoy has won one title before. That was the Malaysia Masters, as we said. He was runner-up to Jonathan Christie at the Swiss Open last year. And actually, he's got better as he's got older. Hit the top 10 this year. So he's really, as I've described him, as like a fine wine. He has aged very well indeed. It's a real contrast to self. Weng Long Yan looking to finish things off as quick as possible. Prannoy has this habit of just trying to wear down opponents. And some might call it Prannoying. Yeah, you can trademark that one.
And on my left, Weng Long Yan, China.
But in all seriousness, it is a style that is tough for players like Weng Long Yan to deal with sometimes.
Level.
They'd probably rather have someone of their similar style coming at them. Prannoy is happy to bide his time if he has to. Having said that, he plays an attacking shot there. Thank you for
one love.
Destroying everything I just said. But early days in this one. Beautifully done by Weng Long Yan. Just to lift that over.
To love.
Prannoy. He's actually also played one other Indian player in a final, and that was Lakshya Sen, who he lost to at the Hilo Open in 2019. Against
three love.
Good start here from Weng Long Yan. Prannoy against Chinese players. There you go. All being very vocal at the moment. Great to hear. That's point on the board for Prannoy.
Three.
So Prannoy gets Chinese players. He's found it harder. He's played them 43 times. He's won just 17 of those, though he has won his last four against Chinese players, dating back to the opening round of the Swiss Open.
Service over. 4-1.
And these are players like Li Shifeng, Xi Yuqi. Good results there. Yeah, tipping the net, helping Prannoy in that one.
Service over. 2-4.
Weng Long Yan. Let's see how he is against players from India overall. Five out of nine against Indian players, including his last one he won. Last two he won, in fact, against Indian players. Three-point lead here for Weng Long Yan.
Service over. 5-2. Thank you.
That's a lovely winner for Prannoy.
Service over. Three, five.
Just for the right moment. Executed that brilliantly. He's up against the left-hander as well, and that can often be quite unusual on the circuit, of course. Not that many left-handed players. A vast minority. Clips it out, I should say. Right-handers are the vast majority of players, I should say. The overwhelming majority of players are right-handers. So facing left-hander is fairly unusual. That means when you're playing your shots, you just got to be aware that where you would normally aim at for the backhand is actually the forehand for a left-hander. So just about changing your thinking.
Play.
Quite often, you'll find that players just do struggle perhaps against when they face a left-hander.
5-all.
In Prannoy's case, his record against left-handers, well, he's lost more than he's won. He's won 14 out of 29 matches against left-handers, so he's won his last two. Just wide. The idea was behind it was good.
Six, five.
But he was quite close to that central line, so you've got to be careful. You have to be a little wider when you play a shot like that, or risk it anyway, on the angle. Just long.
Service over. 6-7.
Tight start to this match so far. His turn to go a little long, Prannoy.
Service over. 8-6.
9-6. Young trying to pull away now. Snatching at that.
10-6.
I just wonder whether it is starting to catch up with him. Some of those long matches he's had.
Five.
Good start here. He suddenly pulled away, didn't he? At the midway point of that first half, Weng Hongyang 11-6 at the interval in game one. Well, this is in danger of running away from Prannoy early on. He's struggling here.
13-6.
Consistency. Prannoy, and he's struggling with that right now. 8 points is the lead.
14-6.
That's had the ability to beat the likes of Lin Dan and Lee Chong Wei and Chen Long in the past. Giant killer. He's had the game, the talent, the weapons to succeed. Intense competition. He's just not had enough titles or finals. And finally breaks that run.
Service over.
That was important for him to
7-14.
Do so. 7 points in a row. Prannoy. He needs a similar sort of run. Remember last year as well, he was part of that historic Thomas Cup victory for India in Bangkok. He did a six-year wait in May when he won the Malaysia Masters.
15-8.
Kind of got a contrast in the two styles because Prannoy is happy to just wear down his opponent, find the right kind of moment. Weng Hongyang is always looking to try and win it, which he eventually does there.
Thank you. Eight. 17-8.
Nine points already. He's clear. Weng Hong Yang. That's going to go out. It's a whopping
18,
huge 10-point lead now for Weng Hong Yang. And I just wonder whether Prannoy is thinking about conserving himself, drawing a line under this one. Looking forward to the second game. He was talking about consistency, pulling through matches and winning them. This one appears to be a write-off. Again, probably could have done better with that.
19-8.
All of his matches, remember, have gone beyond the hour mark. Coming into this one, that sensational knocking out of top seed Anthony Sinisuka Ginting of Indonesia. That one sticks in the mind. That was one of the results of the tournament. Well, this is
20 game points,
very one-sided at the moment. 12 game points here for Weng Hong Yang. Remember, it was not that long ago that they were close at 7-6. So 13 of the last 15 points. Weng Hong Yang has gone on two big runs.
9-20.
Seven-point run and a six-point run. And that's it. The first game done and dusted very quickly indeed. Weng Hong Yang wraps it up with ease, 21-9. And he's looking good here. Prannoy has to do something quite drastic to turn it around. Let's see what happens. See how Prannoy reacts now to the second game. Well, it's Weng Hong Yang quick to complete the point, and that's the difference between the two. Prannoy will do tactically here. Say after winning the semi-final against Priyanshu Rajawat, he said he feels like he deserves some credit because he was ready to accept change and try new things and give it a chance. He's been very grateful to his team providing the input. So it's a real team effort to get him where he is.
Service over.
To find solutions for each and every tournament to keep going. This is Prannoy after winning the semi-final. Even gracious enough to say that Prannoy, Priyanshu was more skilled than he was, which is a big praise indeed. That's more like it. It's a big roar as well. From Prannoy, can just see to his left, the legendary Pulela Gopichand. He needs to tap into a bit of that right now, a bit of Gopi magic, as it were.
Can you check the point?
Well, he did say he had to be composed and stay with Priyanshu in the semi-final. Well, he needs a bit of composure here. Remember, he needed 3 games and 94 minutes to beat Weng Hong Yang in that one. He won the first game in Malaysia that instance. There's nothing to say that he can't turn it around here. Just remember, again, that's gone long. Bei Wentang lost the first game and went on to win. Very close first game, I might add. He also lost the first game to Ginting and went on to win it. So did not count him out just yet. Done well there to get out of that, Prannoy, and to win the point. Well, he looked in danger.
Set is over. 3-4. Thank you.
Just lit a fuse under the other fans here, the Indian fans.
Set is over. 5-3.
Oh!
3.
Well, just as he was starting to catch up with Wong Hong Yang, Prannoy is now trailing by 3. Now, apart from the win against Priyanshu, I'll just remind you that he...
4-6.
All the other three matches he's played have gone beyond an hour and gone to 3 games.
Get ready faster, okay? You're taking too long.
Well, that's a kind of rally you'd expect probably Prannoy to do better in or win.
7-5.
Doesn't last the course. Weng Hong Yang comes out on top. In fact, it was Prannoy who was perhaps looking to get the winner there. And there's a quick look at the screen to see what happened. Twice in this tournament alone, he's come back from a game down to win against Ginting and Chi Yujin. That's more like it from Prannoy. He did it last month against Kidabi Suika, this countryman, at the Japan Open. He lost the first game. Drawn level here.
7-0.
Today against Lee Shi Feng at the Malaysia Masters as well.
Stale ball. 7-0. Play.
Lizzie Jia, the Asian Championships, having lost the first game as well. And he goes in front for the first time.
8-7.
In this match where he's actually had the lead. Let's see how long that lasts. Well, he improves on it.
9-7.
This year, in 2023, I should say, he has had eight matches where he's lost the first and it's gone to three, right? And he has won six of those eight. Talking about Prannoy here. And in fact, if you look at his last match of 2022, he lost the first game against a certain Victor Axelsen. And went on to win the next two. So he's got the staying power. He's got the ability to do it.
Play.
I think he almost thrives on it. As I said, some might find it pranoying. He wears down his opponents at times. And you feel like he's growing from strength to strength, and he's giving glares. He's fired up. He's up for it. Goes into the lead in game two, 3 points up at the interval, 11-8. But it's Weng Yong who's won the first game very convincingly. He's nicely poised at the moment.
Play.
So Camper and I push on from here. Thought was going out, decided to challenge that.
9-11.
Let it go. Yep, actually well in, wasn't it, in the end. A shot that was. Look at the placement. Beautifully positioned. Weng Yong does the subtle quite well as two.
Service over. 12-10.
Trying to narrow the lead here. Staging his comeback.
Service over.
As you said, 12. Quite often it's this interval that can disrupt proceedings. delightful shot. This is the kind of shot she was pulling off against Priyanshu yesterday. Pushing his smashes wide of his opponents, stretching them. Very, very difficult to return.
Quick black and straight back. Okay, thank you.
Stretch for that.
Service over.
Young going for the winner.
12-13. Play.
No one has built up consecutive points for a while now. Oh, into the net. And forced error there from Weng Hong Yang.
14-12.
Still maintains that lead, Prannoy.
Weng Hong Yang, stay on the court.
It's hard. It's hard for either one of these to put on a run at the moment.
13-14.
It's really intense, this period of play. Again, one he ought to be getting over, Weng Hong Yang.
15-13.
He's been in front since it was 7-all. Prannoy.
Blank.
In fact, he's not. Weng Hong Yang was leading up till that point. Been all Prannoy since then.
Service over. 14-15.
That's right at Prannoy. So difficult for him to maneuver when it's aimed at his body. And Weng Hong Yang has drawn level. This is the first time he's done that since it was 7-all. So it could be a really pivotal moment here for the Chinese shuttler. Issue. Prannoy does well to get it back. The rally is still alive. That's an excellent point. Prannoy comes out just on top.
16-15.
Well, that was so good to watch.
Too late.
Well, he wants to. I'm not sure what he's. He wants to ask for.
It's way too late. There's something landed.
Yeah, he's got to ask that earlier. Umpire's completely right, Jitin, but he feels that the point, the shuttle had gone out of play. He's contesting this, but it doesn't matter. He felt it went out. And he's still 16, sort of 15. Pondering over it. It was tough to call. I think at first glance, it was in. Here we go. Hard to tell. It just went across his body as it landed. So you can't really see from that angle whether he had a point. The mainly Chinese crowd is obviously not happy, shall we say, which is understandable. They obviously want their man to win. But that could be a really crucial point in this story. Big roar. Maybe some of that aim there. Well, it's all part of sport, isn't it? Have a look at his reaction as he wins this. Yeah, a little bit of a look up at Jitin Bhatt. Pumped fist. This is why you've got to love sport. There's real emotion out there, there's real feeling about this. Still go either way this game. So much on the line. Quick to the net. He's back in front. And the crowd now, they're cheering again. 16. There were boos just a short while ago. Be clear, it was his right to appeal and ask for a challenge. However, you have to do it very, very soon after the shuttle drops. He was a long, long time before he appealed. I think he may have assumed it was out, not realizing. Anyway, those are the rules. Three very, very crucial points for Weng Hongyang.
18,
and I think he can breathe perhaps a little easier now. He was trailing 15-16. There's terrific noise in here. Well wide.
Service over. 17-18.
That's out. Is it getting challenged? It is, but I think it's a pretty ambitious one from Prannoy. The crowd getting right behind us, very invested in this at the moment. That. It's a massive cheer in the crowd for those Weng Hongyang and China supporters.
It's over. 19-17.
He goes too clear, Prannoy. Actually, it was a lot closer than we thought it would be. Aggression there for Prannoy. He's a point behind.
18-19.
Booing from the crowd, who were saying, why not let him wipe it down? Well, I think they are playing 18, the 19. Extra man here, aren't they? They are trying to get behind him in every which way. Off there, Prannoy. Brilliant from Prannoy. Again, one of those smashes that stretches his opponent.
19-all.
Just an intense rally. This game is really just stirred up the emotions in the last 10 minutes or so. Like nothing else we've seen today. Okay, now, to add to the drama, Weng Hong Young has asked for some medical treatment. It's just on his knee. The knee that is already strapped up, but it seems to be more, you'd imagine. Oh no, he's lifting up some of that bandaging. So that's all sorted.
Okay, thank you, players. Back on court.
This is on a knife edge. Just trying to blunt the rhythm, the momentum of Prannoy here, Weng Hong Young. Can. Oh, that's a wonderful backhand. Prannoy has the game point here.
20, game point 19.
This has swung back and forth. Remember, Prannoy has been leading since it was 7-all. And Weng Hong Young came back into it. That's out. We are all square here at 20-all, and we need a winner by two clear points. More twists and turns in this match. Nicely done by Prannoy. His turn now. And he's got a second game point.
Service over, 21-20.
Can he finish this off?
Can you check as well?
Well, I'll tell you what, Prannoy, whatever happens here, he has done superbly well. Given the circumstances coming into this, how long he's had to play. He's been on the court far longer than his opponent. He's got another game point here. Oh, that's a wonderful smash into the corner. Yeah, Prannoy scrambling there, Weng Hong Yap. He saves his second game point.
Set is over, 21-4.
Prannoy did well to get the shot, but there was never quite enough depth on that. And Weng Hong Yap took his chance. Just beyond the reach. The Indian shuttler. Back to two clear points required.
21-4.
Now, going to be Weng Hong Yap to try and take the advantage here. Out. Unforced error from Weng Hong Yap.
Set is over, 22-21.
A third game point for Prannoy. Now, can he get it that third time lucky, Prannoy, and force a third game? Not ready, says Weng Hong Yap.
Do not delay anymore, okay? No more delay. Take it back.
Well, the umpire has noticed. Has called him out on some of the delay tactics, shall we say, some of the procrastination that has gone on. Prannoy should get it. Game. He's forced a third. What a game that one was.
Second game won by Prannoy.
A marathon second game.
One game more.
It's taken 36 minutes. We've had matches last less than that game. But he's won it 23-21, and into a third we go. We're into the third game now. Prannoy, having won that second game, 23-21, will feel the momentum might be with him. I'll mention the stat that I gave you earlier. Eight times this year, he's lost the first game, and it's gone to three. Okay, bear that in mind. He had years won six of those. So he's statistically, these situations he thrives in. And he's had a good start here in the third. Weng Hong Yang might feel a little dejected after coming so close to wrapping it up. He is up against a top 10 player as well. Reminder again, Prannoy is a number nine player in the world. Weng Hong Yang is 24th, so really in the rankings, Prannoy comes in as the overwhelming favorite.
Set is over. 1-2.
And Weng Hong Yang doesn't have a good record this year. He's only won 10 of 23 matches coming into this tournament. It's been far better for Prannoy. He's won 22 out of 35. This is ranking. I thought that was out. And Weng Hong Yang also feels the same, and therefore he is challenging. And he would be right.
Correction out. Two.
Well, let's have a look at Weng Hong Yang's record against top 10 players. It's actually a very good record,
three,
I have to say.
Two.
It might surprise people, he's actually won 7 of 11 matches against top 10 players, including his last two. Both of them here, actually. Kore Naraoka, as I told you, was world number 4. Beat him in the first round, and then world number 10, Cho Tien Chen, beat him in the quarterfinals. Both comfortably, I might add.
Four,
pretty comfortably.
Two.
So he's got a good record in that sense. Wow, listen to that big roar.
Set it over. 3-4.
Too late. Well, you've got to admit, there are not many players outside the top 10, certainly in the top 20, who've got a winning record against top 10 players. So kudos to Weng Hong Yang. Who, by the way, the Australian Open only got to the second round last year. That's good. It's a great shot just inside the line.
Set is over. 5-3.
Prannoy's performance this year, well, he's also never got beyond the first round in three attempts, 2014, 17 and 19, so brilliant from him as well. Opening up a 3-point lead now. Tight. Yeah, they're all getting a little irritated with each other. You can't be doing that, umpire. That's what Prannoy is saying about Weng Hongyang's behaviour. Gone long now, consecutive point. Oh no, that was in. I think that had gone out.
Service over. 7-5.
Yeah, inside the line. Just the 1 point now, separating the two.
Service over. 8-6.
Just get the impression, the longer this goes on, probably suiting Prannoy more than Weng Hongyang. That's a good shot. A little bit more subtlety from Weng Hongyang.
7-8. Playing.
He seemed to get wrong-footed there, Weng Hongyang.
9-7. Return the shuttle first. Return the shuttle.
Doesn't look particularly pleased with things at the moment.
Thank you. 9-7. Blake.
Again, just taking all the pace off it. Nicely done by Prannoy. He leads by 3. Nice kill shot on the backhand at the net from Weng Hong Yang.
8-10.
Now the Chinese crowd to make some more noise. They went a bit quiet for a little while. He's not had the lead at all in this second game, Weng Hong Yang. On the clear earlier from Weng Hong Yang, and it's Prannoy in front again here at the interval, 11-8 in game 3.
Seconds, you're delaying too much. Do not do that, okay? Play.
Well, it's not the first time the umpire has had words with Weng Hong Yang for just slowing things down, delaying it.
And play.
Yeah, you could call it gamesmanship, others may not be quite so generous. I seem to be well aware of what's going on. And Prannoy has got things off to a great
12,
start.
8.
Weng Hong Yang delivers one of his
9,
own.
12. Fifth set is over. 13-9.
Well, this four-point cushion is going to be very handy for Prannoy. 5 points clear. This is going well for Prannoy. That's good. He's finding his marks.
15.
Weng Hong Young in real trouble. Just out. Well, so yeah. So that's just giving him a little glimmer of hope.
15.
Crowd trying to do everything they can to get behind him. That's two in a row for Weng Hong Young. Might have been going out. That certainly is. He doesn't mind these longer rallies. The war of attrition, that's what he wants to take on.
16-11.
Oh, he's just holding up here. For a second, it looked like there was some concern for Prannoy. Only two players this season, this year, have won the first game against Prannoy and then gone on to win in three. Kwadad Naraoka at the start of the year, the Malaysia Open, and then Lee Chuk Yew at the Korea Open a couple of weeks ago. And right now, while he's still leading by four here, it's not over yet. Prannoy
12-16.
He's on course. Perhaps a seventh win where he has lost his first game and it's gone on to three in 2023. That's a remarkable achievement. But Weng Hong Young, has he still got some tricks up his sleeve? Disappointing for him, an unforced error from Prannoy. Weng Hong Young is only three behind. Well, at one point he was looking very good at 15-9. And so Weng Hong Young has won four of the last 5 points.
Shuffle.
So that has just helped him. He was trailing by six. He's halved that now.
13-16.
It's 11-8 at the break, remember. So it's 5-all since the interval. And that was an important one there. Just to build up a little cushion for Prannoy. Weng Hongyang has to make the move. Four is the key number here. That is the lead. And that is the need for Prannoy to wrap things up. Really good placement from Weng. Stepping one way, rack ahead the other.
14-17.
Just boxing his opponent on that front. Just took a step to his right. And it was too late to play the shot. That's what he's so good at doing.
Service over. 18-14.
Not far away now. If this was a marathon, which it is, well, he has started to get in sight of that finish line. Weng Hongyang not quite on his tail, but not far away. Does Prannoy have enough in the tank to see him across the line? Goes for the flick serve. Well, that's another wonderful shot.
19-14.
And at this stage, with a five-point cushion, he's not going to quite relax, but he knows that it's quite the deficit now. Weng Hongyang has it all to do here. Pulls one back. He just took a step back at the net there.
Service over.
Prannoy.
15-19.
You're not going to see it from here, but he kind of tried to preempt what Weng Hongyang was going to do next. And he got it wrong.
Okay, thank you, players.
This is a man, as I said, who was part of that victorious Thomas Cup win last year in Bangkok. Asian Championships, he got a bronze in 2018. South Asian Games, 2016, he got a silver. These are sort of the things he's achieved. He's got a Youth Olympic silver medal in 2010 in Singapore. Bronze in the World Junior Championships in 2010. He's threatened to win. He's not really done much of that. Malaysia Masters, his only title on the World Tour earlier this year. Weng Hongyang is trying to chip away at this five-point cushion that he had. When it was the Grand Prix, he'd won the Indonesia Masters in 2014, the Swiss Open in 2016, and the US Open in 2017. So he'd won a few titles back then. Well, this is 3 points in a row. Weng Hongyang trying to crank up the pressure.
19.
Oh, this is an excellent match. We talked about that finish line. It's still there for Prannoy, but this time Weng Hongyang really now is right on his tail. Thank you. Good reactions from Weng. Lovely from both players there. The reactions from these players. Oh, this rally continues. So much riding on this point. Well, both players on the ground. We've just witnessed one of the outstanding points of this Australian Open. Both of these players left everything out there. 71 shots, I venture that's the longest rally of the day. And it was a 18, tired shot in the 19. End, it seemed, from Prannoy. Both of them had opportunities to win it. And both of them collapse on the ground. You don't see that very often before match point. We are being treated to some absolutely incredible badminton. And the bigger picture is Weng Hongyang is just a point behind Prannoy, who had, as I mentioned earlier, a very comfortable 5-point cushion. He's just snapped up 4 points on the trot. What is there left to happen in this match? Well, it's been in keeping with everything else we've seen tonight. We are now past the 80-minute mark. It's by far the longest match we've had today. Is there more in this? Is there another twist? Play. Once he gets to 20, Prannoy, the pressure goes right back at Weng Hongyang. Right now, though, it's the Indian player who's got the pressure. Weng Hongyang right behind him. Shot there from Weng Hongyang. And another fantastic shot. Took the pace right off. This young man has held his nerve. 5 points on the trot. 19-0. It looked like Prannoy was destined to win this at 19-14. Weng Hongyang has reeled off 5 in a row. That is simply outstanding. His body language wasn't telling us that story. But he has dug very, very deep indeed. The momentum fully swung back in his favour. Remember, he has not taken the lead at all in this match, in this game, I should say. The only time they were level on scores was at 2-2. Otherwise, Prannoy has led throughout this game. He'll be kicking himself inside, but he's got to focus here. And he has got championship point, Prannoy. What a time to be doing it.
20, match point 19.
But he's only got the one championship point. Thank you. Weng Hong Young draws level at 20 all.
Set it over.
This is the match that keeps on giving. All. Whatever happens from here on in, these two should take a bow for the entertainment they've given us today. And the crowd as well has played a massive part of that as well. Reminder here, we are at 1-1 and 20-20. Point now on the line. He's turned the tables.
20.
He's won 7 of the last 8 points. Listen to that crowd. Now the pressure has turned on Prannoy. It is Weng Hong Young just in front and on the cusp of winning this. He's done it, Weng Hong Young! A brilliant performance. 8 of the last 9 points have gone his way. 14-19 down. It looked like he was out for the count, but Weng Hong Young stuck it out. And Prannoy, it looked like he was on his way. He's beating up the ground now. Weng Hong Young. What a match this has been. His first title since the career open last year, the third in his career on the World Tour. Well, I think he has been magnificent at the end, and a real credit as well to Prannoy. As I said, both these men were brilliant today. The entertainment that they gave us, the statistics were in Prannoy's favour. 6 previous times this year, he'd lost the first game, but went on to win in 3. But it wasn't to be this time. It looked like it was destined when he was 19-14 up. But it's Weng Hong Young of China who beats Prannoy HS, the 6th seed from India, 21-9, 23-21, 22-20. How tight was this? They've done it in a whopping 90 minutes here. But it's been the most absorbing 90 minutes you'll see at the Australian Open 2023. We will have the prize presentation for you very shortly indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, your runner-up of the men's singles from India, Prannoy HS. And making the presentation is Joe Chow from the Australian Badminton League. He is joined by Wendy Weng from Captain Cook Wines. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your winner and 2023 men's singles champion from China, Weng Hong Yang. I'd like to invite Paul Satya from the Satya Group to make this presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, your runner-up and winner of the men's singles for 2023.
Well, it continues the tradition of some fine Chinese winners in the past. Xu Qi, Lu Guangzhu, Chen Long, and Lin Dun, just to name a few. Weng Hong Yang is now the seventh men's singles winner from China here at the Australian Open. Well, catch a breath, take a break. Coming up next, it's men's doubles. Kang Min-hyuk and Seo Seung-jae, the 8th seeds from Korea, taking on the 3rd seeds from Japan. Takuro Hoki, Yugo Kobayashi, our last match of our final day here at Australian Badminton Open 2023. Well, if you've got any energy left, we hope you can enjoy this last match of the day. It is Kang Min-hyuk and Seo Seung-jae, the 8th seeds from Korea, taking on Takuro Hoki and Yugo Kobayashi, our 3rd seeds from Japan, in the men's doubles final. Looking at the brackets there, we had two Chinese Taipei representatives in the semis. Neither one of them made it through. It's Korea versus Japan, always a tasty affair. To the race, to the finals then. Look at that, Indonesia, very strong, unsurprisingly, in men's double. That's one of their fortes. But remember, only two pairs go through to the finals. And it means that Aaron Shia has a, sorry, Herjit Ting, Hong Yu Sin, their partners have a chance to get through.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the players onto the court, Kang Min Hyuk and Seo Seung Jae from Korea.